Hello, welcome back to another session of the Cloud Computing. Today we'll see how we can set up our workspace in our own laptop or desktop and how we can connect to the Google Cloud platform remotely using Visual Studio Code. All right, let's start. The first thing that we need to do is to create a key, and we'll have this key in our computer, in our laptop or desktop, and we'll have to create a new virtual machine and associate this virtual machine with this key. So then we'll use this key in order to connect remotely to our virtual machine. This key comes in two parts, the public and the private key. We use the public key in order to associate this key with the GCP virtual machine. And we have the private key in our computer locally whenever we need to connect to our virtual machine. So I'm here now in my Google Cloud platform. I already logged in under my VM instances in the Compute Engine. So what I will do first is I will create a new public key. I will open my terminal. You can open the terminal if you are in an Apple computer, or if you are in Windows, you can also run the same command in the PowerShell. So it's really up to you. Whenever you are, you can run the appropriate command. It's exactly the same command. So for Windows users, this is the command that you need to run. SSH keygen -c student, that's my username that I will use whenever I want to connect, -f, and this is the folder that I will give, the path, and at the end I will give the name of my key. In this case, it's GCP key. The same applies for the Mac users. SSH keygen -c, the name of the user, in my case is student, -f, the path that is my key. So in my case, just to keep things same, my key will called GCP key. So I will just press an enter, and this will generate my key. If there is a prompt here, it says enter a passphrase. If you want to add an extra security layer, you can add a passphrase. In my case, I will just leave it empty. So I will press enter. Enter same passphrase again. I will just press another time enter, and my public key is ready. In Windows, I will run the same command, and I will have here the prompt that will say enter your passphrase, and just leave it empty, and then generate the key into this particular folder. As you can see here, I have the key in my user's Stelios documents, and I already created a folder called keys. So before you run this command, make sure you create a folder in your document called keys. So you can generate all your keys in this folder and you know exactly what you have. In any case, we'll need to edit the key at some point and import the text in GCP. What I will do now, I will just minimize my windows, and in my Finder, I will go to my folder that is called keys. So go and find the folder that is called keys. And remember, it is under my documents. I just created this folder. I have two keys, the GCP key, that is the private key, and the public key. So make sure you have both keys here and you can see the keys in front of you. The first thing is to edit the public key. So I will just right click on the public key. I will open it with a text editor. Feel free to open it with any text editor you like, Notepad in Windows, for example. And in my case, I will just use the text edit. And I can see here a long string that I will need to select. All right, don't worry about the content, just select everything. You can see it starts with SSH RSA. There is a long string and completes with the username that we used that is called student. So select this, copy this, and have it in your clipboard. We will need to use this text, this string, in our virtual machine. So in my case, I will just go back to GCP. I will click create instance. So let's create a new virtual machine with this particular key. The name of the virtual machine, I will call it Cloud VM. All right, so you can call it as you like. I will not change the region. We discussed about this in the previous session. I will not change the machine type. I will leave it E2 medium with 2 CPU and 4 gigabytes of memory. I will change only the boot disk. In my case, I will make it Ubuntu. Usually we say we'll use Ubuntu in these labs, and the version, it will be 18.04 LTS. The size of the disk, in my case, I will just make it 25 gigabyte, have some space for running some stuff. So select this, and you can see the cost has been increased slightly. That's fine. will allow the HTTP traffic and the HTTPS traffic. I will open this selection here, and I will go down and says here somewhere security, and you can see here it says SSH keys. So let's open this, and we need to add the key that we just copied in our clipboard, and then I will put it here in this security SSH key. So click item and just paste this key as you have it. Just right click and paste, and it should be fine. All right, so click somewhere else. The key is here. Now let's create the virtual machine. So click create. So again, it will take a minute to create the virtual machine. While the virtual machine is created, we know already that we have in this folder the key. So we'll need this folder in order to connect to GCP Cloud. Now, this VM expects us to have this private key in order to connect to the public key that we have in the platform. All right, so the next step for us before we proceed with the GCP, now the VM is ready, you can see it here, but before we do anything, is to click here in the Cloud VM and explore a little bit the virtual machine. We know that the virtual machine is called Cloud VM. The basic configuration about this Ubuntu image that we already used. And if we go down, we will see that there is an SSH key called student, and the key is this one, which is the one that we pasted from our computer. So this is the key here. You can see the whole thing here. That's fine. Okay, it looks fine to me. Let's see how we'll connect in a while, okay? Now, before we proceed, what I want you to do is to go and download the Visual Studio Code. We will need the Visual Studio Code. That is a very cool software for us to use in order to edit our files in the VM. So we'll use the Visual Studio Code. Go to the Google and search for Visual Studio Code and click on the first link actually here. And then select the version that you prefer for your particular computer. In my case, if I am in macOS, I can download this stable macOS. For Windows, download the user installer here. If you are in Linux, you can use the other versions. So go on, please, and download Visual Studio Code. After this, we'll see how we can set up access to our virtual machine from our local computer. So I open my Visual Studio Code. I can see it in front of me. And now what we'll do is we'll try to connect to the virtual machine using the Visual Studio Code from my computer. So I will go here on the left side. You can see here this option that is called extensions. And I will just type here remote SSH. That's the extension of the Visual Studio Code that we need to install before we proceed. Okay, so we need to install this. Just click here, click install. Literally, it takes a second. We have our remote SSH. I will close this, and I will see here that on the left side, now I have a new option that's called Remote Explorer. So click on Remote Explorer, and we will need to create a connection to the virtual machine. To do that, we'll need the IP of the virtual machine and the key that we created. All right, so let's go here and say, I want to create a new connection. Just click on the Add New. The command, you can see this is the command that is recommended, is SSH hello at microsoft.com. In our case, we'll say SSH dash I, and we say, you know, we have a key, so I need to use the key. To use the key, I need to find the key and the path of the key, okay? In my case, I can see that the path of the key is this one, all right? I created it in the previous step, so just copy this from here, okay? So it's in my users, in my documents, in the keys folder, all right? The key name is GCP key, all right? So copy here and go here and paste it in the command, all right? So say SSH using this key, connect using this key, and my user is student. If I go back to my window, I can see that, yes, the username is student. And the user student will connect at this particular IP of the virtual machine. So if you go back to your Google Cloud VM, you will see that your particular IP has an external IP. Copy to clipboard, okay? As we say, always we use the external IP. And paste it here, and it should be fine, right? So I'm ready to connect to my virtual machine. Just press enter. Now you will see another window. In your case, I don't see it here, that says, are you sure you want to connect? Press enter, because I connected before. I don't see it now. So every time you connect for first time, you will see this window that says, are you sure you want to connect? And after you press enter, you will see this screen. Okay, it says here, select SSH configuration file to update. I will click in the first one. And I can see now that the host is added. And also I can see that I can open the configuration file if I want to see it. Just click open config. This is a basic configuration file that says this is the host. As you can see, this is the host. All right. I can change the host name. I don't want to see the IP here. I just want to see here something like, you know, this is a GCP VM. All right. If you like, you can put the name of the virtual machine. So if I go here, I can see it's Cloud VM. All right. So probably let's call it Cloud VM. We have exactly the same name. Okay. The host name is the IP that I use from the GCP. Now, whenever we stop the virtual machine and we open again the virtual machine after like 2 or 3 days, we'll have a new IP, because these IPs are ephemeral. They change as soon as we close the virtual machine. So what we have to do is always go here in this file and just edit the host name. Change the IP to the IP that we have of our virtual machine. It's very easy. I will show you how to do it. All right. Now, the next thing is the GCP key. You can see it's the folder. If you change the key location, you have to update the folder. And finally, the user is student, is the user that we created when we created the key. I can save this, go file save. I can close the configuration file, okay? If I want to open it again, I can see here it's this one, right? Click configure and click the first option. You will see again the same configuration. You can go back and change the IP if you want, all right? Just close this again, that's fine. I can refresh this just to see here that this is the Cloud VM. And now that I have my Cloud VM here, I can just right click and I can click connect to host in current window. All right, so this will try to connect to the virtual machine in our current window. You can see here it says I'm setting the SSH, I'm opening remote, and in the bottom left you will see it says SSH Cloud VM. It looks that it's connected, everything is fine. So if I go back to the Remote Explorer, I can see my tick bottom here. That's fine. All right. So go to Explorer, the first option, and click on Open Folder. Now, this goes directly to your home student. Remember, every user has its own folder under the home directory. All right. So I will click OK, and I will be redirected directly to this Cloud VM in this folder. It says here, do you trust the authors? Yes, I trust the authors. All right. And I can see here a selection of folders and files that already exist in my home student. In reality, these are some scripts that I can create and edit in the future. For the moment, we don't care a lot. What we'll do is we'll go here, it says terminal, and create a new terminal. So the new terminal, it will be actually a terminal for us to connect to virtual machine the same way as we were here in the previous session. And we say, okay, I will click SSH, all right, and I will open the terminal in my browser, but in this case, I open this terminal in my own computer. All right, you will see that it's helpful, and it's literally quite easy for us to work from our computer using the terminal. Now, while this is connecting, I can go back. Well, it's already here. I can see here that I am as user one in Cloud VM. All right, whenever we connect here, we remember that this is our user, the user that we have in the Google Cloud platform. So always we are connected as user one. But I can see, if I say list my folders in the home directory, that there is a user called student. And this student user is the one that we use. Right, so go back to my Visual Studio Code. And what I can do here, I can say ls, I don't have anything. I can create a new folder, I can call it test. Okay, I can list again, I can see the test folder. And now if I want to create a file inside the test folder, I can click here, new file, or I can go file, new file. All right, so go to new file, for example, and say, you know, this is a test file. And if you go file, save as, I can save this file. Now, let's save it in the test folder, because we created a test folder. And I will call it test.txt. It's a test.txt file. Okay, I save it, right? So I can say now, show me the content of the home of the test folder. Okay, sorry, the test folder. And it says, you know, there is a test file there. Okay, also I can say, why you don't show me what is inside the test file? I can run something like that using the cat command, and I will say, you know, this is a test file, all right? So I just created something very simple, all right, inside my virtual machine using Visual Studio Code. So I'm ready to go now. I have my Visual Studio connected to my virtual machine. If I finish my work here, I can go and disconnect. So I have to close these windows. Okay, it says here, do you want to save? Yes, let's save it. That's fine. And I can click here and, you know, close remote connection. I will close remote connection. And this will close the connection to the virtual machine. I can go back and turn off my VM. If I want to connect again, I have to go to Remote Explorer. Now everything is here. I have it here from the previous connection, so you don't have to do it again. If you want to change the IP because you turn on and turn off the VM, you can go here and you click the config and you change the IP. Just copy and paste the new IP always in this location. If you want to connect, just right click connect in current window and you will again connect to the virtual machine. You can see here it says opening remote, and then I can go here again to Explorer, open folder, go to home test, open my files, and I can see here in my SSH folder now, in my cloud VM, I'm connected SSH. This is the session restored from what I did before. I can click here, clear, type here, clear. I can see the test folder. I can see the test file. I can open it. All right, so I can go back and do whatever I want. If I go now to my Google Cloud, I can see here that I have a home student, and I can see that in student home there is a folder called test and there is a file called test.txt, and I can say, you know, show me what is inside this test file. I have to put all the path, right? So we have to get used to using the paths in the Ubuntu, and it says, you know, this is a test file, all right? So that's good news, because now we have our workspace ready. And we can do more things now. We'll go directly with the use of the Linux environment, some basic commands, how we can create a new web application using Node.js. This is the things that we'll see in the next classes, but we are ready to go for our next sessions. All right, so that would be all for today. We just created a new key. We associated this key with the Google Cloud Platform. A new virtual machine that we just created, and then we used Visual Studio Code in order to connect remotely for our computer to the virtual machine. As you can see here, I have to now close my VM, leave the terminal, and then, as always, you can just go and stop the virtual machine. Always stop the virtual machine so we will not get charged while we're not using the virtual machine. That would be all for this session. I will see you again soon in our next session.